Hello. This video is a look at ChatGPT at its current state at the time of recording of this video in late April 2023. I want to evaluate the usefulness of ChatGPT to aid Python programming of control programs for simple electronic components attached to Raspberry Pi GPIO. I am using standard Raspberry Pi OS image on Raspberry Pi 400 hardware. My circuit is very simple. I have an LED attached through a current limiting resistor to GPIO 26 and a push button attached to GPIO 21. The reference program, which I wrote by hand, allows starting and stopping LED blinking through repeated presses of the button. My program exits gracefully through Ctrl-C key combination, closing breadboard components. My goal is to prompt ChatGPT to produce a program similar to mine. Let me start with a full prompt, requesting a complete program. Write a Python program for Raspberry Pi to continuously blink an LED connected to GPIO 26. Blinking start-stop will be controlled by a button connected to GPIO 21. Exit gracefully through Ctrl-C, closing all breadboard components. I got a response with a program using RPyGPIO library. Program structure looks okay on the surface. Required inputs at the top. GPIO initialization section. A button callback function which toggles the LED on off. Button setup for falling edge of the signal tied to the above function as a callback. An infinite loop which continuously turns the LED on and off. And finally, a graceful exit through Ctrl-C. I am not sure whether this program fulfills my requirements, and I will test the code in a moment, but let's have a quick look at the explanation section first. Fairly brief, but I see an odd thing in the last paragraph. I am instructed to run the program with superuser permissions, which is not what I would consider normal with this program. Let's find out more about that. Why superuser permissions? The bot gives me a rundown why a superuser or root permissions are needed. I see a full command featuring sudo, which is the correct keyword required for superuser privileges when running a program. Right after, I am told that superuser permissions can also be achieved by adding a shebang line at the top of the program, adding execute permissions to the program file, and running the program with the .slash prefix. This is unfortunately mostly wrong. First of all, superuser permissions are normally not needed when accessing regular GPIO pins through RPyGPIO. Program execution through sudo was something used years ago, but has been changed over 6 years ago, and ChatGPT should be well aware of that. Secondly, running a program in the shell with sudo has nothing to do with the shebang line, at least not the way this example is written. This program can be run with or without the shebang line, and it definitely does not need sudo. Let me test the bot's conviction about this. Are you sure? Sudo has not been required to access GPIO on Raspberry Pi in years. Whoops, looks like something crashed. I'm sure this is just a coincidence. ChatGPT has been a bit slow today, but I find the timing funny. I will ask this question later again, but we'll test the program in the meantime. I will use Nano Editor to keep it simple. Save the program and run it. Okay, so the LED starts blinking right away. I was expecting the program to start with the LED being off, but I suppose my prompt was not clear on that. Let's see what happens when I press the button. There seems to be a disruption of the blinking, but the blinking does not stop when I press the button. It looks to me that the button starts the blinking with every press. It may stop the blinking very briefly, but I cannot tell from visual observation. The program exits fine with Ctrl-C key combination. Let me take a break to allow ChatGPT to come back online, and I will ask the superuser question again then. Okay, I'm back. Let's probe the bot's conviction about superuser requirement to run this program. Are you sure? Sudo has not been required for GPIO access with Raspberry Pi in years. Decent recovery, although I did not appreciate being led down this path of confusion. At the same time, now I am being suggested to that running a program with Python or Python 3 is equivalent, which is also not true. Using just Python invokes Python version 2, which is deprecated, and unless there is a specific reason to do so, only Python 3 should be used today. I think that I will write this chat off as a dead end and start over. Let's see how ChatGPT does second time around. I will use initial prompt identical to last time. My experience with ChatGPT has been that an identical prompt produces a different response each time. Maybe this time the program will actually work as expected. This program is shorter than last time, and it does not use a callback function. This does not necessarily mean it is inferior. I don't like how the button and LED state are tied together within the program loop. Such code is difficult to debug, especially considering that both states are continuously changing as the program runs. Also, the attempt to debounce the button to prevent false button presses from being detected is very clumsy, as the sleep delay within that section may affect the blinking frequency, making the blinking irregular. Let's test the program anyway. As before, I will use Nano Editor to make the program file and run the program in the shell using Python 3 interpreter. The LED starts blinking right away without any button press, just like before. Well, I'm able to stop the blinking on occasion. It seems that the button only works while the LED is on, but even then I'm having trouble to get it to work consistently. Of course, I could now debug the program and see if I can fix it, but my objective is to get the desired outcome through interaction with the bot. I am essentially pretending not to know much on the subject. Let's regenerate the response. Perhaps I will get a better program this time. Right off the bat, I see an odd thing here. Sleep for 1/10 of a second under the try section. A naive and inefficient approach to make sure that try section is not empty. If nothing was to be done here, then a pass statement would be more appropriate. However, a better solution would have the infinite while loop within the try block as it was in the previous response. Anyway, let's give it a try. This time the LED is off when the program starts. I press the button and the LED blinks once. Interesting. Oh, now I get it. This time the button successfully and reliably controls the blinking action, but through holding and not pressing as I requested. It seems that the bot cannot distinguish between pressing and holding events, as it clearly refers to a button press in program explanation. This is an improvement over previous two times, but again, not quite what I wanted. Let's see if I can clear up the button hold versus press confusion. LED only blinks while I hold the button. I want to control blinking through button presses, not holds. Here's a side-by-side comparison of previous and current version of the program. A new state variable has been introduced to track whether the blinking is active. This variable is flipped from true to false and vice versa with each button press. This is a good move, although I am not thrilled about how all this is accomplished, especially due to an introduction of a nested while loop, probably intended to debounce the button. Such loop is very inefficient and perfectly avoidable. Blinking and button handling are synchronized in the same loop. What a mess. Let's see how this plays out in reality. This kind of works, but it's very inconsistent. Oh, I see. It appears that blinking starts with a press, but stopping the blinking requires a hold. The confusion of pressing versus holding a button persists. Also, due to the complex loop structure, the program now does not exit cleanly with Ctrl-C, leaving the LED energized after the program exit. Considering how the program works and the more convoluted nature of it, I see this response as a step back. Let me try to push this conversation in a different direction. Button pressing outcome is very inconsistent. It looks like the bot is trying to tie the problem to button bounce, but I know this is not true. The issue is clearly due to confusion between button press and hold. The program is getting longer and more confusing. I see now time interval calculations as an attempt to mitigate the button bounce. Let me try and run the program. Yeah, this does not work at all. Let's give the bot a bit of help and point it in the right direction. Rewrite the program using another library. Here comes gpiozero, what should be shown to me from the beginning. A newer and a much better library than ArpyGPIO. Programs written using gpiozero are shorter and much simpler than their equivalents written using ArpyGPIO. Less code means less opportunities to mess up, in my opinion anyway. This program structure is fairly straightforward. Component setup at the top. A function which blinks the LED once. Button is registered to handle press events with a callback function that toggles a blink state variable. There is an infinite loop which blinks the LED continuously if the blink state variable is true. Using an infinite loop, especially with GPIO0 LED, is not the best approach, but let me try this program anyway as is. Well, look at that. It actually works as expected. All right. Now that I have it working, I want to make it better. Clean up the code, make it more efficient and more straightforward. Let's start with getting rid of the loop. GPIO0 can blink LEDs without using a loop, so let's see if the bot knows about that. Rewrite the program so it does not use any loops. What is this? The program has been rewritten, all right, including a different method to handle Ctrl-C. The weirdest part here is the new while loop, although I asked not to have one, which continuously calls the button callback function, also expecting me to press the LED in the process. LEDs do not have functionality associated with pressing them. Now that's hilarious. So wrong. It's as if you throw a stick and tell your dog to fetch it, and it brings you back a dead squirrel. Total garbage. This program will not work, and I'm not even trying it. Let me repeat myself. I don't want any loops. Also, the blinking function does not have any sleep delays in the pattern now. There is the loop again. It seems that the bot is stuck in a loop about using loops. Other than persistent looping, I see now a couple of lines where this program handles several button events while only one is needed to handle simple presses. Wow! ChatGPT is heralded as a tool that can optimize code. Let's see if it can clean up its own mess. Simplify the program without losing any functionality. I've learned the hard way to add a stipulation to keep existing functionality with such requests, otherwise the bot will routinely cut out vital portion of the program just to make it shorter. As far as I can tell, the only optimization is in the blink LED function. Now, instead of repeated LED on-off calls, the program uses the blink method, which is indeed simpler. This also fixes the previous problem of missing sleep delays, which were necessary before. Interestingly, code explanation talks about removing the blink state variable, deeming it strictly not needed, yet the variable is clearly still in the code. I am not impressed, and I don't think this program will work very well, if at all, but I'll try it anyway. The program starts this time. Okay. Let's see what happens when I press the button. Whoops. The LED blinks once and the program crashes. Nicely done, ChatGPT. All right. So far, I am not impressed. While I got something eventually that worked as expected, it took multiple prompts to get there, and the resulting code was less than ideal. Generally, it looks to me that ChatGPT is flailing without a coherent direction, sometimes even producing code that is completely broken. I appreciate that I can pose my queries in natural language, but even that does not always work, as demonstrated through the persistent inclusion of loops in programs generated, ignoring specific instructions to the opposite. I think I need a break. To be continued in the next video, keep watching, it will get better. I think.